that's the first thing I learned in Canada, that the violation of human rights for the new immigrants, it's very common because they exploit us. You know, the senior people or the management or the big bosses, because they know that the new immigrants, they don't have the courage, and especially the Muslims, because we are an easy target for everyone. As an international person, immigrant, I believe that surviving under dollar 11 or 12, it's a disaster. So many times I was not able to provide lunch to my kids. My job was not only the survival of Malka, but the family of Malka as well. Each and every single worker, they deserve the same raise. They deserve the same 15 and fairness kind of stuff. Our contract was expired last year. So we had to put everything, all the points for our survival of the workers in the new contract. So, and it was not that easy. At York University, I'm really thankful to them, like our students, faculty, the unions over there, QP, Local 75, the rest of the unions, the community members, they involved with us. They were our encouragement. They gave us the strength to stand up and fight back. And I think everybody got encouraged, provoked to stand up and went for a strike, even though it was very hard in a rough, tough weather of winter. By winning a strong contract, we win almost 100% benefits for ourselves. And we also win the successorship rights. It's in Bill 148. And I hope that it's on the table and it will be approved by the government. I'm very thankful. I'm very obliged to my company, Aramark, because they are the one who turned me into a strong, into a very, very courageous fighter of Unite Here Local 75.